Cinde'ella, get back to work.
Thank you. I've got a halo and a hat, but my halo I don't wear. I've got a halo and a hat, my halo I don't wear. I'm gonna shake that halo until I get up there.
Hey. Good evening.
Hey, man.
Hello, Mrs. Blunt. Is Rose upstairs?
Why, no, she's not back from work yet.
Well, it's just that I thought she might want to walk down to the library with me.
You're going to the library again?
Well, I finished this, so I've got to give myself something to read.
You know, I used to love reading, but lately, I just seem to get out of the habit.
Wow, you know, I wouldn't know how to get along without reading. I mean, Emmy's wanted me to food or sleep or anything. You know, I read at least one book every day since I was 10, and I can always remember that I... Right. Well, if you'll excuse me, I've got to go, or the library will be closing.
Well, I'll tell Rose that you were asking for me.
Thank you.
No problem. Oh, such a nice boy. So sweet and gentle.
Certainly can't have much on his mind. He's got time for all that reading.
I think it's wonderful to have something like that, to put your heart and soul into. Rose says he's just about the smartest boy she's ever met, and then one day he's liable to...
Oh, good evening, ladies.
Good evening, Mr. Buchanan.
Well, I hope it's hot enough for you.
Oh, how's your wife doing in this weather?
She don't complain much about the weather, but she's afraid to leave the house. Afraid she wouldn't make it back in time in case, you know?
Yeah. I was the same way with my Vincent, but with May, I was up and out until the very last minute.
Mm. Mr. Buchanan, do you think your wife might like some minestrone, some good Italian vegetable soup?
Much obliged, Miss Fiorentina, but she can't seem to keep anything down. That's why I ran out to get her some orange. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sort of teary, I guess. I'll sure be glad when this is over.
Honest, the way these men carry on, you'd think it was them having the baby.
Well, in a way, I think it's harder for the man. No, I mean it.
When a woman has a baby, assuming that she can, she shouldn't overlook the fact it's awful hard on a man.
When a woman has a baby, it is hard on a man.
Tryouts. And they're going to repay for tomorrow.
Yeah, about it.
Why nothing? Willie's off playing, and I guess Rose is still at work.
Never heard of nobody working nights at a real estate office.
Well, the office is closed tomorrow on account of Mr. Gordon's funeral. He was the head of the firm.
Never mind all that.
She shouldn't be staying out nights without us knowing where she is.
Well, she didn't say a word about Mom's coming home, but...
That's what I'm saying, ain't it? It's a mother's place to know.
Thank you.
had a day like this. It was up to 94 at 3 p.m.
Yeah, six dead in Chicago. Ain't no relief in sight.
Well, it's good for the milk business.
Yeah, I'm just after pouring half a bottle down the sink.
Don't throw it away. Just make, what do you call it? Schmackos.
Oh, yes, pop cheese. My wife makes it too. Once in a while.
Is your wife all right again? You were telling me last time she was sick.
Was I? Oh, sure, sure. That was a couple of weeks ago. Yeah, sure. She's all right again.
And you got a family too, ain't ya?
Yes. Yes, I have two little girls. Well, I told my wife I'd go down to the drugstore to get her some nice cold ginger ale.
If you ask me, that gassy stuff don't do you a bit of good.
Well, it's good for the milk business. Well, good night, folks. See you all again.
What's that bird's name? Sankey, right?
Yeah, Mr. Sankey.
He's the collector for the milk company.
Mrs. Fiorentino, it's for your nice